continue the same chapter, that is matter around us pure. Till the last lecture, we had discussed about the properties of true solution, suspension and colloids. Now, let's do the comparative study of these three type of solutions, because the comparative study is the most convenient way to just learn the differences between all these. Okay, so let's start with the particle size, because we know the particle size is the main basis for the classification of solution into these three categories. So what is the particle size of true solution? So you can write, particle size is less than 1 nanometer. Here, the particle size is more than 1000 nanometer. And for colloids, the particle size is in between these two, that is 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer. Now let's have a look on the second point of difference, that is homogeneous or heterogeneous. So true solution, all of we know it is homogeneous in nature. This suspension is heterogeneous in nature, and colloids are heterogeneous but it appears to be homogeneous. Next point is, true solutions are stable, suspension are unstable, and colloids are stable. So all of these points are given in the previous lecture, so I am not describing it. We are just doing the comparative study about these three types of solution. Now the next one is, the particles cannot be seen with the naked eyes. Here, particles are visible, and here, particles can be seen by ultramicroscope. Next is, how can we separate these? So, it cannot be separated by filtration method, that is a normal physical method to separate the mixture. It can be separated by filtration, and this colloids cannot be get separated by filtration technique, so we use a special technique here, that is centrifugation. In detail, we read about the centrifugation in the coming lectures. Centrifugation is used for separation of the components. So these are the main points. One more you can write about the Tyndall effect. Since the particle size is very small in true solution, they do not scatter beam of light. Suspension, they may or may not scatter the beam of light. Or colloids, they scatter beam of light, that is they show the Tyndall effect. So these are the major points on the basis of which we can do the comparative study of these types of solutions. true solution, suspension and colloids. This is just the recapitulation of the topic that we have read earlier, that is the properties of true solution, suspension and colloidal. Now in our NCRT, after all this, we are having the various separation techniques. So let's start the first separation technique given in your book, that is separation of dye from ink. So the first thing that we have to separate is separation of dye from ink. Ink, which we use for writing purpose or for the other things, is actually the mixture of the coloring agent, that is dye, with water. Now, how can we separate the dye, blue dye or black dye, from that ink solution? So for that, we use technique evaporation. Already in chapter 1, you have read about the term evaporation and all those factors on which it depends. So the technique here we use is evaporation. Now, what is the principle behind it? The principle is, if two components are mixed together, one of the component has low boiling point, which evaporates easily, than the other one having high boiling point. Now, let's have a look on this picture. Here I have made one burner and a beaker containing water, and on that a petri dish. Here you have seen it in your chemistry lab, petri dish which contains the ink from which we have to separate the dye. Now, this is actually the indirect heating, because we have taken water in the beaker and we are heating this ink with the help of steam created by this water. You can also take water bath. So, we heat it by steam or by indirect heating. What happens? When we heat it directly, along with the water, the dye content also evaporates. So we use the indirect heating here. So when we heat it, what happens? All the water components evaporates and the dye remains here in the petri dish. And by this method, we can separate the dye from the ink. Since my drawing is not that much beautiful, or you can say that is not very good, so I'm providing one of the video of this separation technique for your better understanding. So from the next class, we'll continue the different or the other separation methods for separating different components. Till then, let's ask the questions based on this topic. Thank you.